The devil would not want us to see this verse at all. You know what? Let me read it again for you. I want us to read together. Verse 19. And what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe? According to the power that worketh his, according to the working of his mighty power. Do you know what he is saying there? He is saying, in other words, when our spiritual eyes open, when we begin to see from a spiritual perspective how this life operates, how this Christian walk is, we will then begin to understand how much power is available to us. Can you understand now why the devil wants to knock us off? You know, someone once said, the devil trembles when the weakest saint is on his knees praying. Can you understand why the devil would want to make the prayer meeting the weakest service? Put on your spiritual eyes this morning. Can you understand that if the devil could keep us from not praying, or keep us from praying, and if the devil could keep us from reading our Bibles, do you know how much power and how great he feels? Because the believer, the simple believer, who understands the Word of God and who practices the Word of God is a force to be reckoned with. Come on, if those in the back hear what I'm saying. The simple believer who gets on his knees and he begins to storm the throne of grace, and we don't have to storm the throne of grace, by the way, it's open wide for us. The simple believer who goes to God in prayer and talks to God and gets up, ah, my goodness, power is available to him. So that's why the devil will try his utmost best to stop us from praying and to stop us from reading our Bible. Because hear how Paul describes this power. You see, this power is more than just some kind of electricity power that comes from some electric company. He says this power that he's talking about is the same power God used to raise Christ from the dead. Hello? I wonder if you follow what I'm saying this morning. You're going home just now, but get me this point. The same power that is available to us, Paul is saying, is the same power that God used to raise Christ from the grave. Dead, wrapped up in all sort of cloth, tomb in front of, stone in front of the tomb. And God, on the third day, the Bible says, he rose him, raised him from the grave, and the tombs were moved, the stones were moved, and he walked out triumphantly, hallelujah, conquering death and hell. Amen. That same power God used is available to every believer here in this church this morning. He said that same power is the power that he used to put him at the right hand in heavenly places, far above all principalities and powers, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also that which is to come. Till another writer says that at the name of Jesus one day, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. That power is available to us. Then you could understand why the scripture says we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Then you could understand when the scripture says, when John writes that greater is he that is than he that is in the world. But the problem really is not that the power is not there. Not that we are not important to God. But the problem is how we see. That's what the problem is. A couple weeks ago, picked up my glasses. I put it on my eyes. I just couldn't see. Couldn't see at all. I was in the office and I struggled my way to go home and I said, Lydia, Lydia, like a going blind girl. Can't see. And then she said, what to the lens in your glasses? One of the lens dropped out. I said that to say this. If you don't have on the lens, you can't see right. If you don't have on the lens of the Spirit, and if you can't see through the eyes of the Spirit, you will never see clearly. And so many Christians, they have on glasses, they look like Christians. No lens. Lens drop out. Can't see right. And because you can't see right, you bounce into things that you shouldn't bounce into. You get knocked down when you're supposed to be safe. Because you do not have on, we do not have on our spiritual lens that comes from the Holy Spirit's enlightenment. Oh, that God would help all of us this morning to become enlightened by the Holy Spirit. You know how we get enlightened by the Holy Spirit? By simply learning to yield to the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Because the battle really is in the flesh. And we are constantly feeling that we must always stay in the flesh. We have to operate in the flesh. In fact, some of us are bold-faced enough to say, let me deal with this brother in the flesh. But hear what? They that in the flesh cannot please God. And true Pentecostals walk in the Spirit so that they will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Stand with me, please, this morning. Stand with me, please, this morning.